Hello, everyone. How's everyone doing today? Everyone doing good? Great. Awesome. We got some more people still logging in, but we're going to get going here. Thanks for joining today. Excited to have you guys. Excited for this topic. One of my passions after 30 years in sales to, before becoming a coach, to actually now just talk all about sales and what helped build over $6 billion in revenue over the last three decades. Yes, I've been doing it that long. You guys, I'm going to allow you the ability to take yourself off mute. I want this to be interactive. There's going to absolutely, if you got questions, I want you to just speak up, kind of as if some of you I know seen on here have been to one of my live presentations at the UT Club in the Marriott Hotel. So don't hesitate to just speak up as you would there. Obviously, if you're not talking, if you can put yourself on mute so that I don't have to do that, because I want to make sure, like I said, everyone can just speak up when they want to. And I want this to be very interactive as we talk about. So make sure you got a pen and paper, whatever you do. I like to take color and, I like to take notes, and I have actually looks like a pen from fifth grade, all the different colors. Our brain sees in colors. So think about that the next time you're at a workshop, you're learning. You'll see in my notes, I got anything on my desk, the notes, I write in multiple colors. And each color kind of means something. It's how our brain works when we want to go back and look at it. Also, you can use the chat feature. It goes directly to me. The chat will just go to me. Obviously, if it's something you really want to shout it out, because I'm not looking too much at the chat. I'm trying to focus on what we're doing here. At the end, we're going to have some options to help you guys out and how we get going. So with that being said, looks like I'm just going to keep an eye on who keeps logging in here. So if you see me looking over, that's what I'm doing. I'm not ignoring you guys. So let's get started. Again, build your sales system and skyrocket to instant success. Who here wants to double their customers before this year's up? Does that sound good, everyone? Awesome. All right. We're going to have a lot of those raise your hand and answer the question moments today. I want to kick you guys off right away because I want you to be thinking about this. You're going to be offered some complimentary coaching at the end. You're going to have a couple different options here. A 30-minute coaching session, complimentary, or a 75-minute business strategy session, kind of pivot strategy, how we figure out where you're at and what we build a roadmap to where you want to get to. So think about that. Type in the chat at some point which you want. You can type in 30-minute or business strategy as you think about it as we go. And I'll show you later on how you actually get on the calendar for that stuff too. All right. And actually, it's right there. You go to the website, webelieveingrowth.com. Over the right side of the website, you see the coach's calendar, and you got those top two options right there to get yourself going here. All righty. I got into coaching after a 30-year career because I want to be able to help our community, help our business owners. So I do a lot of complimentary coaching to get you a little started to see if coaching makes sense for you and to get you, just help you. Sometimes you just need help take that first step. So please take advantage of that. I want to thank you for your attendance today. I also want to congratulate you on your attendance. One of the most important things we do in life is invest in ourselves. And as business owners, sometimes we don't feel we can because we're running our business. We've got 1,000 things going on. Now we got to get home and take care of the family. So I want to thank you for making the time to invest in yourself and not therefore your business as well. We know our most valuable asset is our time. As you heard him say, you can make more money, but you can't make more time. I don't know of anyone who's created the time machine. If you do, I'd like to see it. I'd like to go ahead, figure out what the winning lottery numbers are, so and come back and play. Business doesn't mean busyness. We hear that a lot. How often do we look at ourselves and really working in our business and not on our business, right? You know, we're just responding to emails all day long where everything becomes an emergency. Want to make sure business does not mean busyness. And in coaching, we work with you as our clients in that. That's not something we're going to touch too much on today. Today's all about sales and sales systems, but just a reminder, and today is you working on your business. So again, congratulations on that. How you invest your time, you know, is one of the keys to business success. So, bit about learn to make sure you get the most out of learning. And I know there's a couple people on here who have been to some of my workshops, so you know what this slide is. How many here have raised some children or have some children and you hear them say, I know? Or maybe from our spouses and our partners sometimes. When we say, I know, think about our kids. It's not, hey, I know, with a smile. It's, I know, right? We're putting up a block. You are absolutely going to hear things today that I promise you've heard before. I'm going to guarantee you that. But are you going to hear and learn something different by being open to listening instead of saying, I know, and shutting yourself down? So instead of, I know, how about, isn't that interesting? Isn't that interesting? How do you say it? Isn't that interesting and put up a block versus isn't that interesting with a smile on your face? So I want you to keep that in mind as we move forward here. All right. The other thing with learning, we want to have some fun. This is going to be interactive. We are going to interact a lot. We are going to really just get going here. Like, let's have some fun. Let's participate. That's going to be very important, participation today. A couple things. It's kind of an action coach thing, what you can expect. What we call BFOs, blind flashes of the obvious. When you get one of those, write it down. Write it down so you can remember it. Like I said with me, it's in different colors. I write in different colors. For you guys, write it down. Highlight it. I have highlighters too when I'm in a learning scenario so that you can come back to it. Maybe you'll have a question on it. Write it down. Stop obviously anywhere along the way and ask me a question. Unmute yourself, but write them down. All right. So big question to get started. Just want to ask you guys, can I be your coach today? Is that all right? Is it okay if I coach you guys today for a little bit here? Sound good? Awesome. I appreciate that. So one of the things I love doing most, out of all the things I do in an action coach business owner, and I am a business owner, a lot of people say, you're a coach. I go, yes, I am. I'm a coach. But that's the business I own. So as a business owner, one of my favorite things to do is actually what we're doing today, is these workshops where we can really get a whole bunch of amazing business owners and entrepreneurs like yourself together and do some interactive learning. So my purpose today is very simple. I want to reward your time. Again, congratulations for investing in you and in your business. And we're going to reward that time with showing you how to increase your sales and profits. By the systems we talk about for sales, how we actually free up your time, right? Free up your time too from that. Think about that. I love in the beginning of coaching with new clients, we talk about, we're going to double your customers and give you more time outside your business. Does that sound good? Right? That we can actually double the money we make, but have more time to enjoy it. And that's a big thing of what coaching is about. Action Coach has a definition of a business, a commercial profitable enterprise that works without you. And without you means something different for everyone. And that's something we dive into in coaching to understand what that means when we work one-on-one. But we're going to do that. And part of freeing up your time is how we create an amazing team. And that's all part of a sales system, as you can imagine. So why coaching? Why are we talking about sales systems today? The problem we're really trying to solve, and what Action Coach is trying to solve, is that approximately 80% of businesses fail in the first 5 years, and 90% in the first 10. And my goal, the Action Coach goal, is to make sure we reduce these stats specifically for me here in Austin, in the Austin community, but globally, all of Action Coach. And as you can see down there, the business life cycle, 70 to 75 of businesses. You know, let me ask you by show of hands, who here has an exit strategy for their business? Right? There's two exit strategies though. The first one is the definition, a business that works without you. The second is, do you sell it? Do the kids take it over? Things along that line. And that's part of the business life cycle. So focusing on sales so we can grow that business, to invest back into it, to build a team, to have a business that can run without you. This is one of the many systems and processes that we build for, we help our clients build through coaching. Today, again, is focused just on sales so that we, when we get into phase four, it's about growth, right? We want to keep growing. We want to create that wealth event in retirement in phase five. So a little bit about Action Coach. We are the world's number one business coaching firm. We're in over 84 countries, over 1,000 franchise owners. Action Coach is a franchise. So I'm a franchise owner and over 1,000 coaches. I also am a coach, as I've said, and we also have, a lot of us have coaches under us. We're privately owned by Brad Sugars. I know a lot of you I see on here, familiar faces, have been networking with me and are on some different of my social media. So you see some of Brad. He's been out there. He created this over 30 years ago. Our vision is really simple. It's to create world abundance through business re-education. And what we mean by world abundance is there's more than enough out there for everyone. I go to a lot of networking events where there's three other coaches in the room. Nancy, I know you go, and there's a few other insurance agents in the room too who own agencies. But there's enough business for all of us. Some are going to like me more than they like someone else, and some aren't going to like me, and they're going to like Paul or John or Jane who's coaching. There's world abundance. And think about in Austin, we're about 2.3, 2.4 million. In the next 20 years, it's estimated that Austin will grow to 5.5 million people. Who's excited for that traffic? No one's excited for that traffic. That's world abundance, but it's through business re-education. Who here was taught to be a business owner? Who went to school to be a business owner? All right? Not so much. We do some workshops. Maybe we go to a couple things. But we've never been taught to be a business owner. And the business re-education is to get us out of a mindset of being an employee. And we're going to talk a lot about mindset today and what we do. Okay? So we want to get out of the mindset of being an employee. That's one of the business re-educations we talk about. We'll go through some of that today as well. Again, we're in over 15,000 businesses each week that we coach. A little bit about me. I think it's important to know who I am as we get started here so you know my background. These are the two kids who I've raised. As you can see, that's them every day since they were born. Always having fun, always trying to make jokes. But then they grow up. The oldest likes this picture a lot because his little brother's caught up. He's 6'5", the one in the black sweater there. I'm real proud of them. My oldest proudly served in the military for 6 years. He's now working on his own business. The oldest is working on becoming a baseball player professionally. It's just real proud of what those kids do. And if it wasn't for that amazing woman in the middle, that's my mom with three of her four grandkids there, then none of this would be possible. This is my why. This is why I do what I do. A little bit more about me. Like I said, 3 decades of building businesses of all sizes, building sales systems. We're going to talk about those sales systems today. That's a combination of what Action Coach has done, as well as what we've generated over what I've helped generate over $6 billion in lifetime revenue. So that's what we're going to be talking about. Mindset. I want to take a poll here. The first thing in any success in sales is a mindset. I've always said, if I have someone who has a mindset for sales, I can turn them into, this is what I've always felt, I could turn them into an amazing salesperson. So I want you to type in the chat box. And this only goes to me, so you can type whatever you want. We got someone there waiting to get in. Let's get her in. When you think today, especially with everything that's going on, we're not going to harp too much on what's going on with COVID. We're talking about sales systems. Sales systems work no matter what's going on. You have to have a system. I'll also say this as we get into this. This system works whether you're a sole proprietor or you have 100 employees or somewhere in the middle. It's all the same of what we have to do to bring sustainable success day in and day out that's repeatable for ourselves and for our team members. So I want you to look at that. What's your mindset today? Are you feeling inspired? Are you a little further down at hopeful? Maybe you're anxious and fearful. If you can just type those in the chat box, like I said, that only goes to me. But if guys can all type that in, let's take a minute there. Here's the interactive part we're going to be doing. Good. Does everyone see where their chat box is? I know we got a few more that have not responded yet. Good. Overall, we got some, we're at the top end, the top three. And that's good. And that's where we want to be. Obviously, we always want to be optimistic and inspired. How do we get into a mindset? So we're going to talk a bit about mindset right now because that is actually part one of a sales system. Do we have the right mindset? So, oops, let me get on there so we can get going here. For a couple people who just joined, just a couple things. You have the ability to take yourself off mute. This is going to be interactive. I want you to just, if you got a question, take yourself off mute and speak up. When you don't, please put yourself back on mute so we don't have the background noise. But please let this be interactive. This is how we're going to get the most out of it. At the end, we're going to show you a couple options we showed you at the beginning. You're going to have two options to choose from. I want everyone to choose. Do you want to have a complimentary 30-minute coaching session to help talk about some whatever you want to talk about in regards to your business? Or do you want to get into a full 75-minute business strategy, pivot strategy session for your business so we can build things to a plan for you? And those are complimentary just for being here. Again, my way of helping our Austin community. So keep that in mind. We'll show you later how we can get into that. So, all right, let's move on. Formula for change. This is something Action Coach and Brad came up with a long time ago. And when you think about this, when you look at yourself and you haven't made change, or you think about maybe it's one of your kids, your spouse, a friend, a coworker, why haven't they changed? What are they resistant to? And that's let's what does this look at? D is dissatisfaction, meaning this, you know, this is a very powerful formula to keep in mind here. I am dissatisfied with where I'm currently at and what's going on. How dissatisfied are you? Times vision. I have a vision, a clarity of what it will be like when I make this change. Not what it takes to make the change, but what it is after I make this change. And so those two are multiplied, which means they're obviously more important when we look at the formula. And then that's just plus the first step. What's the first thing I got to do? And that all needs to be greater when you add it up from a numerical standpoint than the resistance to change. Now, prior to COVID, we worked a lot on when we had clients or team members, people in our lives who were resistant to change. It typically had to do with both a combination of dissatisfaction and vision. Let me give you an example. Because just because you're dissatisfied with something doesn't mean you want to change. I've used this example because it's still the same one. I've been using this example about myself for a while now. For the last year, I've said I want to lose a good 12 pounds. I don't like that I have 12 pounds that I want to lose, but I know what the first steps are. Don't eat the potato chips I had with my sandwich today for lunch. Maybe drink wine every other night instead of every night. And go to the gym a little more. Those are the first steps. Those are easy. I can see that. The vision, I have clarity in the vision. I know how the shirts will fit, how my, jackets will fit, how I'll look. I like that. And on a scale of 1 to 10, the first steps, I'm probably at a 9 of knowing what that is. My vision, I'm probably at an 8 or 9 as well. But my dissatisfaction, obviously, is probably about a 1 or 2. It's not high enough when you add all that up and multiply to get me to do what I have to do. So when you think about that with someone at work, someone at home, or yourself, why, I'm sure you have times where you look at, why am I not changing? What's your level of dissatisfaction? Now, with everything that's going on with COVID, a lot of people dissatisfaction is anywhere from a 9 to a 10 to a 1,000. But a lot of people do not have a clear vision of what it looks like when this is over. So I can have a 9 out of 10 on dissatisfaction, but if I only have a 1 out of 10 on vision, I don't have a lot when you add that all up and multiply what's going on. And then if I don't have the vision, what's my first step? I might be at a 0 on first step. That's where a lot of people are today. So they are resistant to change, or better yet, opposite of resistance to change is willing to accept change, which is where we want to get to. So when we look at mindset, when we look at some of the things we're going to learn today about your sales system, there's going to be some things you're going to have to change. Are you willing to make the changes? Do you have a fear, false expectations appearing real? Do you have any fears to change, whether it's for your sales system or the other things in your life? So think about that. Now, what brings those fears? We call it the identity iceberg. What sank the Titanic? Was it the top? No, it was the bottom part, right? Below the water. So what's below the water in our lives? It's our identity. What do we identify with? Who do we identify ourselves with in crisis? What is my identity? Has it changed during this crisis before it was, or has it solidified? What are my value system, right? I want you to think for a second about that, how your identity affects your values and how your values affect your identity and how your beliefs, how this all starts stacking up on each other. What do I believe? Do I believe we can get out of it through this and grow our business? Who here believes we can grow our business today in the middle of all this? That's awesome. I love it. All the hands are up. That's where we want to get to. You guys are ahead of the game there. That goes to our skills. Do we have the right skill set to come through this? Maybe we don't, but I'm on a workshop today because I have the values in learning and believe I can do it. I just need some help. So I'm here to learn a new skill set or improve my skill set. This is all the environment someone lives in. So when you think back to the formula for change, you think if someone's cranky with you today, what's the environment below the surface that you can't see? Because that's affecting their behavior. It's also affecting think about this for ourselves, our own behavior. Are we picking up the phone more and cold calling? Or are we hiding and not sure what to do to grow our business? How's that affecting our decisions? If we don't have confidence, our decisions aren't as good. In our actions, how is all that below the surface affecting, and this all stacks on each other and will drive the results we have? Does that make sense? Yeah, good. All right, point of power. We'll say above or below the point. I use this in my own life. I use this in coaching all the time when I work with clients. I use this on my kids too, by the way. Below the point. It was what we call bed, blame, excuse, denial. And when we're below the point, our energy's down, our ability to do things is down, we are powerless. We do not have power. We're not in a position of power. Think about, you can probably look at something, whether it's yourself or someone else in your life in the last few hours that you interacted with, and they had blame or an excuse or denial as to why they had reasons. Why didn't something get done? Even in business today with what's going on, blame. Oh, you know, it's the politicians. They're not giving us enough money to build our business, to get our business open. Oh, the excuses. Well, no one wants to buy during this COVID thing. Everyone's holding on to the money they have. Denial. You know, what are some of the denial things we're hearing out there about COVID? That's all below the point. My job as a coach, and when we coach together, and our job as leaders, by the way, you're all leaders in your organizations, your communities, to help lift people above the point, to a point of power, to feel powerful, right? That's the or, ownership, accountability, responsibility. Think about it from this standpoint. If we're in a rowboat, and right now the seas we're all rowing in, the waves are a little big, the currents and the winds are strong, and they're pushing against us. For some business, they're actually pushing our sails in the right direction. But if I don't have an oar, do I have control of where I'm going? No. So when we stay above the point, we get control of the oars. I'm not saying we don't have to row hard sometimes, but we have control and we can still get to where we want to go. We just got to figure out how to work there. And that's what we're going to talk about from a sales standpoint. So we get the results we want. Does that make sense with everyone? All right. Because the only failure in life is the failure to participate. So I want you to think about how you're participating or choosing. By the way, above the point, we get to choose. So how are we choosing right now to participate with everything that's going on? What's something new, if you want to open up your mic, what's something new you've chosen to do in your business to get to a point of growth or to help your team members or yourself feel good right now as we keep getting through this? Anyone want to share a way they've participated in that sense? All right, we got a bashful crowd. So I want you to think about, how are we participating every day? think about it this way. I know some of you, you have team members that you are the manager of, the business owner, the leader. When they're struggling, do you participate by calling them into your office to sit down and find out what's going on? Maybe there's something going on at home. Maybe they're just not understanding. Or do you just not participate and hope it gets better? That's a form of way we can participate. You're participating in your knowledge today by being here, but how are you participating in your everyday? All right. So we want to build a strong mindset. How do we do that? And this is it's a system. And this is a system that goes into sales. This is the sales system. This is an operations system, a customer support, and daily rituals, right? What are your daily rituals every day? Anyone want to share some of their daily rituals, how they start their day besides a cup of caffeine that helps set their mindset into, I'm going to have a good day? What are some of the things we do here? Anyone? I promise you'll get tired of my voice.
I read every morning.
Awesome. Thank you, Dan. I appreciate that. I do too. One of the great, great books, I just finished it and I've put it into play, is called The Miracle Morning by Hal Elroy. If you have not, write it down. If you have not read that book, The Miracle Morning, looks like Dan's a reader. Back in January, I tried to start getting up at 5 a.m. and go through about a 90-minute ritual, and I struggled with it for 2 weeks and I stopped. And then finally got this book, and now I'm back to getting up at 5 a.m. and going through my ritual. All right? And my ritual is, it's a combination of silence. I get into affirmation statements. I get into gratitude, thinking about things, spending 5 minutes just thinking, what am I grateful for today? I get into visualization. How do I visualize what today, obviously this morning I visualized what we'd be doing tonight or this afternoon here, different things like that. And I throw in some exercise, and then journal. He talks about journaling, something I've always wanted to do, which I feel I'm horrible at, which that statement is below the point, by the way. I journal. And right now, sometimes some of the journal I said is, I'm supposed to be journaling for the next 10 minutes and I don't know what to write. And next thing you know, I start writing some other things. That's one of my daily rituals. I get out of bed. I don't hit the snooze. I do not turn on the news. I do not, especially nowadays, I do not turn on the news. We got to learn and grow, right? That's part of our mindset. Today you're here learning. Opportunity, not crisis. What's our mindset about what's going on with the COVID pandemic? There's an opportunity. I have a client who's more than doubled her business in the last 6 weeks, right? Because she's in a mindset of growth. Now, I know there's some businesses out there that right now you are shut down. I get that. But what's the mindset of opportunity when the doors open and we want to grab market share? How are you celebrating the wins each day? And as I said, no news is good news. I understand you got to watch a little, but the less you watch, the better. We at Action Coach preach, do not watch the news. The first 59 minutes of your day will set your tone. So think about your rituals, all right? So let's get into the business stuff. We want to be successful. There are 5 keys to success. And obviously, we're going to be talking about the first one today, sales and marketing. Now, the interesting thing about sales and marketing is that you do not need more customers to double your customers. Now, a couple of you on here have been at one of my workshops. Think about that. I want to open this up for a quick dialogue. How do you double your customers without adding more customers? Anyone?
You go back to your regular, your clients that you already have, and work with them on additional products or whatever situation they may be in.
You got it, the ladder of loyalty. I think, Nancy, you were at that workshop where we were going over the ladder of loyalty. Yes. When's the last time you guys called your customers and got more business from them? Right? So sales and marketing, we have to have a system in place. The next key, if this would move for me, leverage. How do we simply stating do more with less? Technology. This is what we're talking about, systemizing the routine and humanizing the exceptions. 80% of what we do in business, today we're going to talk about the sales system, is systematized. We have a strict process. It's written out. We have a flow chart so that we can hire a temp off the street because we got so busy, who can just read it real fast and fumble through it, right? 80% systematized, 20% is humanized. Of course, there's going to be exceptions, so we leave room for that. Systems, right, are your key to unlimited leverage. We talked about a commercial profitable business that works without you. It's about the systems. When you have the right systems in place, you don't have to be there. I have one of my clients who's a CPA. They weren't that busy this year. By the way, we built their business by over 40% this season. They worked less hours because we have a system in place that they didn't before. Think about that. 40% growth, and they've only been in coaching since December, and they didn't have to work more hours. Who here feels they could do 40% more business and actually get home earlier? Who would like that? Right? Systems, of all the things we look at here. And systems probably ties to all of them. And then obviously people. Our greatest asset is our people. I think we all agree with that. And I know, like I said, I've got some great new people on here. I'm happy to meet you here. And we got some other people I've met before. I know how well you take care of your people. They are our most valuable asset. So the ultimate blueprint for a successful business, it starts with our assets. And I bring this up because assets need to effectively turn into sales. And that's what we're talking about today. So in order to build the system, we have to know the assets we have. What are some of the assets, and anyone wants to shout out, what are some of the assets we have that we can that help us grow our sales? Think back to the last slide, what was on the bottom, our most important asset we have. People. Yeah, thank you. People. People's one of our most important assets. The products we sell. So the goal here, though, is how do we effectively turn assets into sales so that we can then efficiently, and today we're going to focus all on sales, but I want you to see where sales fits into the formula. Sales, how do we turn them into profits? Right? Efficiently turn sales into profits. And very simple, the fastest path to profit maximization is reducing the drag of expenses. So when you're buying, for some of you, you know, maybe you have a delivery truck. One of my clients who is a residential HVAC. Do you want to spend, if we have a truck that's going out and servicing all the homes out in the Georgetown and Round Rock area, are we going to get any more money from our clients if we buy a brand new $20,000 truck versus a used $5,000 truck? We're not. But what we're going to do is get less profit. So think about the assets. Warren Buffett, he's the second or third richest guy in the world these days. If you go to his office in Omaha, Nebraska, it's kind of the old IKEA furniture, ripped, nice carpet, but not plush. It's just a simple office because there's no reason to invest in $10,000 chairs. It's not going to increase sales. It's only going to reduce profit. And obviously profit productively has to turn into cash flow. Cash flow is what we get to take home. And you're going to hear this one later on. What gets measured is what gets managed. So in order to go from each of these, we need to be measuring what's going on. We need to be measuring our results and our activities. So we said our most important part of our asset we have is our team, is our people. So what are the keys to a winning team? It starts with you guys here. Strong leadership, right? Common goals, and that comes from you articulating as a leader the goals down to the team. Why does the top sales rep want to be the top sales rep? How does that fit into your goals as a company? How is your goals as a company helping them grow as an individual? What are the rules of the game? We're going to talk a lot about metrics and KPIs and activity today. That's a big part of sales systems, right? Makes sense. So you need to share the rules of the team. You got to have an action plan. Who here does a 90-day plan every quarter for their business? All right, not less than half the hands went up there. You need to have a plan so that we can then figure out what we need to measure and where we're trying to get to. If we don't know where we're getting to, then how do we know we're measuring the right stuff, the right activity, the right, what we call KPIs, key performance indicators, which we are going to dive into. Got to have a plan every 90 days. In this COVID, we did a 90-day plan in April 1st, and then beginning of May, as we saw where things were shifting, we actually updated and redid the 90-day plan for our clients. That's what we do in coaching because there's a lot of change going on. So we want to stay ahead of it. We want to be proactive. We want to be innovative. We want to see where opportunities are. Support risk-taking. How many here feel they truly, that they're both themselves as a salesperson and anyone on your team, they feel comfortable taking risk and failing, that they're not going to get in trouble for it? That makes sense? Yeah, about 50%. Support risk-taking, let them take a risk, let them try new things. Obviously, if there's a lot of cash to spend in that risk, you as a business owner want to have some control and say over that, but it's okay to take risk. That's how you grow exponentially. And 100% involvement and inclusion. Does that make sense? All right. So I want everyone to open up their microphones, and I want to, before I kind of show you what I think they are, I want to hear you guys shout out. Think for a minute. What are the components of a high-performing sales organization? I'm going to call on everyone if you don't yell it out.
Planning.
Hmm?
Planning.
Planning, yep. What else?
Attitude.
Training.
Training.
Making the most of your skill sets.
Oh, great. Great. Good stuff. All part of it. Number one, in my opinion, is leadership. We talked about the keys to a winning team. Leadership. Right? And I'm gonna show you these, and then we're actually gonna go into each one. We're gonna get into how each one affects how we build our sales systems. Team, we all said that. The right people in the right seats. We have an opportunity right now. And in times of crisis, there's opportunity. And that opportunity is there's some great people looking for new jobs. So if you're in a growth mindset, maybe you got some money from the PPP that's helping support you from the SBA loans. Maybe you got some cash on hand and you see the opportunity. There's some great people looking for some jobs. And especially in a time like this, they are going to be very grateful for that job. And they are going to work their butts off for you. So look at the opportunity. Are there some good people? There's an opportunity for growth in your business. Systems and process. Have you guys heard that from me at all today? System and process? It's a lot of system and process. That's in when we coach together, system and process, system and process. It always comes back there. So what are your sales stages? We're going to talk about that. And what CRM to track and systematize the process? Who here is using, actually has a CRM system? Okay, we got a couple. Good. Very important. How else are you going to do all this stuff? Scripts for every interaction. Who here has a script written out for their 30-second speech when they go to a networking event? I do. Who has a script for when someone calls and asks, you know, how do we book an appointment? Or how do we sign up with you? How do we buy from you? Scripts in your customer service if they're talking to a customer. Who here feels they've got a good handle on who their target client is, who their A-list client is? Who feels that if I asked you right now to tell me what the characteristics of your A-list client is, that you within 90% accuracy could give that to me? Who feels they could do that? We got a couple of hands and a couple. How do we know how to fix to have the right messaging if we don't know who we're targeting? So we're going to dive into that as well. USP, unique selling proposition. I am going to ask you guys later when we get there to actually articulate your unique selling proposition. And I'm not going to give you a lot of time to be able to tell it to me because it's going to highlight where we need to get to. And is it backed by a guarantee? Who here has a guarantee in their business? Yeah. A guarantee, by the way, we're going to dive into that, is not about money always. Right? My HVAC client, he sells an air conditioner. There's a manufacturer guarantee. But we actually will work on what, we'll talk about what guarantees he offers that have nothing to do with money. Critical drivers and KPIs. Critical, right? This is really important. I'm assuming most people have heard of KPIs if you've read any business book. But KPIs are actually not that important. They're a lagging indicator. An example of a KPI is sales. How much did we sell? We sold $1,000 today. But if we don't focus on what I call the key predictable indicators, critical drivers, and we're going to dive into this, how do we predict that that's our activities that tell us we can forecast the $1,000 we're going to get every day? And that's where a lot of books, in my opinion, go wrong. And a lot of workshops you go to, they talk about KPIs, but they don't talk about the critical drivers. How do we drive that KPI to increase sales, to double our customers? Sorry, there's a few more components. There's a lot to building a sales organization. And each of our businesses has a sales organization in it. Whether you're a sole proprietor or you've got 2 employees, 10 employees, 1,000 employees, this is everything you need to be doing. For a sole proprietor, leadership is about self-leadership, right? Training program. We talked earlier, when we asked you, one of you guys shouted out training program. Absolutely. Right? I congratulate you earlier for being on here to learn. This is a training program for you to be even more successful in your business. And celebrate the wins often. Who here feels they when you think about it, in the last 30 days has celebrated a win in your life or in your business? About half the hands went up, not all of them. Think about that, right? We're high performance people, but we're not always celebrating the wins. It all gets into mindset. So, all right, let's get into leadership. Number one, and then Simon Sinek, if you know him, he wrote the book Starts With Why, which is one of his most famous ones. He's someone I've followed for years. People don't buy what you do. They buy why you do it. And he talks about the golden circle, why, how, what. My why is very simple, to help people remove the perceived ceilings and walls they put around themselves that hold them back from truly reaching the heights that they were meant to and capable of reaching. That's why I'm a coach. Think about your why and can you articulate it to get people not to follow you, but to enroll in your vision. So I want to have a couple, shout out a couple things. What do you think are some of the characteristics are important in being a great leader that gets people to not just follow them, and not because you have a title, but because they want to be a part of your vision? To the group, someone shout something out. Or if you're more comfortable, type it in the chat box and I'll shout it out.
Positive energy.
Positive energy, yep, that's a good one. What else?
Oops. Integrity.
Integrity, absolutely. How about clarity? In your why, I just gave you clarity. I told you what my why is. That's how I run my organization. That's how I run my organization. And vision and mission. It's how I am as a father to an 18-year-old is going to be 19 next week, and a 26-year-old. You have to have clarity. Clarity and so people understand what type of leader and where you're trying to lead us to. Character. Is character important? We could probably talk a good half hour on what character means, couldn't we? Really dive into that. Empathy. By the way, one of the most important things in a great salesperson is empathy. But it starts with leadership. Are we empathetic? Do we care? Do we show that we care, right? Selflessness. That one makes sense? Oops. Focus. If you want people to be high performers, and sales is all about high performance, it's got to have focus. So do you have focus in what your why is? Do you focus on executing on that? Executing on, we talked about training programs, executing on the system. Are you leading by example with focus? Are you a teacher? Great leaders are teachers. They are absolutely teachers and mentors. You got to bring passion to what you do. I think you guys can hear me, my voice, and as I move my hands around a lot, and I'm probably moving around a lot because I love, for some of you who've been to some of my workshops live, you'll see I move around a lot. I want to get that passion, that energy out there and share it and feel it back from you guys, right? Got to have passion as a leader in what you believe in and what you're doing. Because if you're the leader and you don't have passion, why the heck would I follow you, right? Why would I work harder to build sales, to grow the business if you're not passionate? You got to be available. Anyone, what does that mean in leadership, being available? Anyone want to take a crack at that one?
You would have to share your time.
Absolutely. Thank you, Sherry. I appreciate that. Yeah. You hear it of the old adage, living in the ivory tower. A lot of CEOs living in the ivory tower. The last company that I ran, I reported to the CEO, part of the executive team. I was a senior VP of sales. Both the CEO and I sat on the opposite ends of the big open floor, and everyone was welcome to come into our offices. And a lot of times, by the way, I grabbed my laptop and I went and sat out on the sales floor and worked with them. And this way they could ask me questions. They could hear what I was talking about. We were available. Our CEO was always available. And if his door was closed for 3 hours, all he had to do is get on his calendar for 10 minutes and he always would accept it. Got to be available. Got to be a good listener. I think that's an easy one. There's a great book out there. One of the books I love the most. It's called Never Split the Difference by Chris Voss. He was one of the lead FBI negotiators in the 80s, 90s, into this century. And he talks about active listening skills. You have to be a great listener. And if you want to learn more about that, let me know afterwards. And I'll give you a little 5-minute excerpt from it. On an Audible, I actually recorded it, and we can have a conversation about what is active listening. How can you be a great salesperson, by the way, if you don't listen? Who hears, right? Right there. How many times have you had someone call you on the phone and just shout at you, and you answer, and they just kept going on a path because they didn't listen to anything you said? Did you buy from them? Probably not, right? By the way, this 2-hour workshop, and I am condensing a 2-day offsite retreat I do with companies just on sales systems, how to do sales. We would absolutely spend about 1.5 hours just on active listening skills. So a lot of this is bullet point, and we got to stay high level so we can get through as much as possible in our time here today. But these are things in coaching that, based on where the business is, when we come in and coach, help you with your sales team, and help you, we dive deeper into these things. Self-discipline, right? You know, Dan mentioned earlier in his daily rituals, I think we both read the same book based on how he nodded his head. There's discipline, there's self-discipline. Now, by the way, you don't have to wake up at 5 a.m. If your day starts at 10 a.m., you work a later shift, or maybe you work the night shift, the miracle morning's about, before you get going, you wake up, you go through the miracle morning. That's self-discipline. Doesn't always have to be 5 a.m., so don't be afraid of that. Someone who is maybe a bartender at night or runs a restaurant, their miracle morning might start at 2 p.m. before they go to the restaurant, when restaurants are open. Positivity. It's kind of hard to be positive sometimes when there's a lot going on. Remember the identity iceberg with everything that's going on there, right? Can we be positive? Sales is about positivity. We have to show positivity in what we're doing. Our salespeople have to be positive. And that starts top down from the leaders. Coachable. I think that's pretty self-explanatory. And just because I'm a coach doesn't mean I threw it on there. You want a great book on leadership, John Maxwell's 21 Keys to Leadership, and he's written a few different books. He's a great author on leadership you can go listen to, John Maxwell. So let's get into the team. Steve Jobs, I love this quote, and I won't read every quote I put up here, but I will read this one. It doesn't make sense to hire smart people and tell them what to do. We hire smart people so they can tell us what to do. Now, when we have a system in place, we allow them to come in and maximize the system and to improve on it, right? We're talking high level today about the sales system, but it starts with, we said our most valuable assets are team. So of course, if we're gonna focus on a sales system, we're gonna talk about how do we build a team, right? So it starts with character, characteristics for each role. It did. So the last company I worked for, these are the competencies, I know you can't read that so much, that we had. I'll give you the high level. I have six bullet points on here. And by the way, none of this has to do with their ability to sell. I mean, their sales skill, technical skill. Passion to succeed. Demonstrate a track record of success. I do want to see that. Empathy, integrity and trustworthiness. Selling and influencing and coachability. Six things that have nothing to do is, do they know, are they from the software industry? Have they sold cars before? I don't care about that. I care about their character. I want the right people joining my team who believe in our mission. That's heart over technical skills. So think about the people you've hired throughout maybe you were a manager for a company before you became a business owner, or even you've been in companies, you've seen good and bad hires, and I made some bad hires. Technical skills does not build culture. It's what's in here, the heart. And we're small businesses, so we need to even more so focus on the heart and that they fit the culture. Go back to the leadership traits and the vision, the mission, the focus. Are they going to fit in that? We can teach a lot of technical skills, but we can't teach them to care enough, to have a heart, to believe in the same mission that we have. Who here has an interview process for their business? Truly written out, where if I said, show me the interview process, you could pull a document or even pull it out of your head and say, here's the five things we do. So when we coach you, we actually have Brad Sugars, our founder. I think you can see we've got a bunch of books back here. Instant team building. It's all about an interview process. You got to have a process because in the end, we want to write an ad that inspires them to enroll. Just because someone's looking for a sales job doesn't mean they're going to come to us. We want to inspire them to enroll, not just apply. We got to be able to tell a story. We want them to be able to share stories back of how they've been successful in life. We want them to actually deselect us. We want our process to be a little difficult so that they deselect us so that all that's left are the best. And part of that deselection is, wow, does the ad inspire high performance? And maybe I'm not that high performer. Then DISC. DISC is a behavioral, DISC, Martin Briggs have guys kind of heard different behavioral analysis. Some of you may have heard of DISC. It's one, I'm a DISC certified practitioner. DISC is something that before you give someone a final offer, do a DISC profile on them. Understand who they are. See, now for each role, you should understand what DISC profiles usually do best. And that's something we coach on as well. And DISC also, we won't get into it today, but DISC also gets involved in how we interact with our clients. Imagine if I know, communication is not what I say, it's what you hear. If I understand DISC, so there's four categories, D-I-S-C. If I understand which personality, which behavioral trait is dominant for you, I can then communicate on the phone or with you as a coworker in your language so you can actually hear what I have to say and we can connect. With them, what's in it for me? You hear that a lot with Action Coach. As kids, we're all a little selfish, sometimes even more so as the parents, as we'd say. But we don't fully grow out of that. So with them, what's in it for me? When you're interviewing people, you need to understand they're with them. And is that something you can offer them? And especially, you know, if it's a, you know, if we talked about this 2 months ago, we'd say what a tight labor market is, below 4% unemployment, da da da. How can we attract great talent? Well, even now, so there's still great talent. There's great talent out there, and some of it's going to stay. Are you, by the way, holding on to your great talent? How are you doing that? Right? How are you building up your team? I like to say it this way, to steal a quote, membership has its privileges. You want to be an employer of choice. And not everyone gets to come and work for you or work with you. I think that's the better way to say it, and be part of our team. So keep that in mind. But it all goes into, all this fills into the interview process. Have it written out. Understand what you're looking for, the what's important. And then actually create questions. I actually have a document that has over 20 interview questions on it. I don't ask all 20 in an interview when I interview someone to be on my team, because some of those questions lead me down a path and I want to hear more. But I already have it written out. I have a system, right? So we talked in sales, systems and process. I love this. I don't know who this guy was, but I love the quote. 94% of problems in business are systems driven, and only 6% are people driven. So I want you to think about that in your business right now. What are some of the issues you have? Or what maybe isn't going as well as you want? And we can get below the point and say, well, it's because of COVID. We can put blame there. Or is it a system issue? Do we need to make a tweak to our system? When you think about that, myself included, yeah, I know a couple systems I still got to get better at. Is that fair to say? Everyone agree with that? Right? So what are systems? Saving yourself time, energy, and money. We talked about this earlier when we talked about the keys to a successful company, to a business. We have to have systems in place. This is how we leverage, how we get more with less, how we divide to multiply. And that's something we can talk hours on, right? So sales stages. Let's dive into this for a little bit. Who here has define sales stages for their sales process? Stage one is the cold call, the introduction. Who has that? Right? Not too many hands going up there. And that's okay. That's why we're here. We're learning. We need to know each sales stage. How many? So for me, I can say the first part of my sales stage is typically is the quick introduction. That's typically either at a networking event or someone has a quick 10-minute call we book through social media. Stage two is they have a complimentary 30-minute coaching session, or they book the 75-minute business strategy session. And at the end of that, they become a client. So it's a quick three-step process. I know the purpose of each one. Who here still does some cold calling? Anyone? Anyone, shout out an answer. What's the purpose of the cold call? How do you, when you get off that cold call and you say that was successful, what happened that tells you it was successful?
Practice.
I'll say that again, David.
Practice,
yep. Anyone else? What's success? For everyone, it's different.
Understanding their business.
Okay. Did you book the next step though? So I've always taught this in cold call. We've booked the, to simplify, and all that you guys said falls under that. Thank you for sharing. Falls under, did you book the next step? So in my last job, my last company I ran for my team, we had a six-step sales process. Some of them for companies can get long, but each is important. It's just, it was a bigger sale. The cold call was to book the first meeting. So the definition of success was I had a cold call and I booked a meeting to learn more. All right. So think about that. And then that next meeting was the success definition of that meeting was they agreed we were selling a software to a 60-minute, after we talked about what's important, where are their pain points, what do they need, we booked a live demo. Right? And then at the demo, the success there was they were willing to send us information, they asked for a proposal. And then the proposal meeting was we closed the sale. That was the definition of success. So you see, very specifically, we know what success is in each step. So think about that in your business. What is success in each step? And once you know that, it's kind of working backwards. And you say, all right, step one is they book the next meeting. Let's just simplify it for a second. I can work backwards to what are the components to get them to say yes to the meeting. So that's why I believe anyone, when we get into scripts, by the way, we have a script there. We can give someone a script. I've been selling for over almost 30 years, not over, almost. Got another couple of years till it becomes 30. Even when I, go to a networking event, I have a script printed out. It's in my car. I read it for a few minutes before I go into, wherever the event is. I read the script. When I was used to cold call, I had it on my desk. I had a whole bunch of different things I wanted that helped me, including the script for depending what process. Was I cold calling to book a meeting or was I in the proposal? I scripted it out. Okay, you got to think about that. How do you script it out? And that script will connect with what's success in that step. Does that make sense? Okay, any questions there? This is why we need a CRM. If you have a CRM and you have, Scott Finkelstein in there, part of the CRM, that's your client relationship management system. You have all your prospects in there and your clients too, but just from a prospect standpoint, what stage are they? Are they a lead that now becomes stage one, stage two, stage three? Stage three is a win and you title each stage. You need to have that CRM so you can track it. And based on the stage they are in or what they call in, you're not going to remember everyone you've talked to, especially when we double your business and we have that many leads coming in, right? You just quickly pull them up in the CRM. Oh, who's this? Oh, hey, Linda, thanks for calling and typing away. So, Linda, hey, yeah, it looks like we spoke 3 weeks ago and you had some questions there. What's going on today? Or how was your vacation? Because I put some notes in there, what we call CNEs, critical non-essentials. Hey, how was your trip? Did you have a good cruise? Was the weather good? It's all right there. It allows you to connect, to have empathy, to connect with that person. You need that CRM to tie into the top. Otherwise, how are you managing this? Part of the systems in the process, this all goes into what we call our five ways business chassis. Now, this is some of you who've been to some of the workshops, you've seen what this is. This is really the sales funnel part of the system. You can go to YouTube and go Action Coach Five Ways, and you'll see a video. You'll see a whole bunch of videos from Brad Sugars and a whole bunch of other action coaches on what the five ways is. Go look at it, write that down. YouTube, five ways, action coach. And obviously when you're gonna book later today at the end of here, you're either gonna do a 30-minute coaching session or the 75-minute strategy. We can focus on your five ways and just go into your direct numbers. We can do that as well. So write it down in detail, flow chart. I asked earlier, who can pull out their, we were talking about the interview process. Do you have it written out? Every step, even with a flow chart, if they say yes, you go here. If they say no, you go here and you come back. That becomes your training manual. We talked, everyone said one of the most important things in a sales organization is training, and we had it on the list. This becomes your training manual, is that process, systems and process. Does that make sense? All right, what's the benefit of a system? Everyone agree Albert Einstein's one of the smartest guys ever to live? Is that a fair statement? Compound interest is the eighth wonder of the world. He who understands it earns it. He who doesn't pays it. Everyone know what compound interest is, or does anyone want to share what compound interest is? Where are my math people? Compound interest is...
Compound interest is if, say, you have an account that makes 5%. So you put $1,000 in there this year. At the end of the year, you'll have $1,050. Is that right?
Yes.
And so next year, it's going to earn 5% on $1,050. So it just keeps building up, compounding over time.
Yep, you're getting interest on the interest.
Perfect. Hard to find something that pays that consistently with.
It does. But you know what pays for it in your business?
What's that?
You know what pays for it, does it in your business, is a system. Yeah. Thank you for that, Dan. It's systems. Systems is all about leveraging. Divide to multiply, to compound, as Dan was talking about. How do we compound? How do we get more from less? Systems is about leveraging. You want a business that works without you? You better have a lot of systems. Now, for some of our business, some systems, by the way, are small. There's 3 steps done, we're done. Others might have 20 steps. There's a sales system. This is all part of the sales system we're talking about today, to double our customers. Then once we double them, what's our customer support system? So that we talked earlier, we can double our customers from our current customers. What's our operations? What's our shipping? If we're shipping a product, do we have a shipping system? We've got to leverage it. And when we have a system in place, we don't have to think so much, so we can do it faster. All right. Scripts. That's pretty interesting. Pretty interesting stat up there. Scripts increase success by 40 to 60% in every interaction. So if we script out every interaction, do you think you could double your business now? Not saying overnight it doubles, but you're well on your way. Is that fair? If we can increase every interaction, which means we take a lead and we convert it into a client, stage 1 cold call, through scripting, we convert, we increase our conversion rate to they book the next meeting. Imagine if we just did about 15% increase from each one. That's why scripts are so important. So what's the key to a good script, though? It's short and it's not complicated. Just to the point. Now, when we get into, like I talked about my last company, we got into the 1-hour demo. The script had stages to it with each stage of each slide of the demo. But we weren't talking for 10 minutes. Who here thinks I have notes on the screen you can't see right now that's giving me ideas? Of course. I've done this presentation twice in the last week, because by the way, this is something new I put together. It took a lot of different things we have. I created this training for this, which is what I'm going to be doing on a regular basis. Of course I have notes. Things in notes, which are my script, so that I don't miss anything, right? So short and not complicated. Know what you're trying to accomplish. We talked about in sales stages, I have a cold call to book the next meeting. So what are we trying to accomplish in that script? Is that script asking them to do something? Get them to listen, ask a question. Some of you who've been to me at a networking event, sometimes I just start with, hey, how many business owners do we have in here? And what's everyone do? Oh, hold on. Yeah, that's me. They put the phone down, or they at least stop looking at it. And they pay attention. Now I've got my 30 seconds to ask them, to get them to do what I want them to do. I want to connect emotionally. Part of my script is going to connect emotionally with them. Right? And I want to offer something of value that connects the emotion with an actionable ask. And the most important part of all, smile. Got to have energy. So who wants to unmute themselves and give me their 30-second speech if they were at a networking event right now? All right. I'll give you mine. And it stays consistent. Now, obviously, with COVID, I've changed some things, but it stays pretty consistent. So I was at a networking event this morning or yesterday? I forget. And so I started off with, who here believes we can grow in during this, you know, grow our businesses, start to grow our businesses during COVID? Great. Whoever has some clients who need to grow their businesses during COVID and when we come out? Great. So I asked two questions. So I try to capture as many people as possible. If you don't have a question, that's going to capture everyone. Great. Who here is struggling with what the plan is for growth or could use some guidance? So what I do is this Thursday at 3 o'clock, we're doing a workshop. It's complimentary to everyone here. And we're going to talk just about how to double our customers through the right sales systems. If you're interested in learning how to double your customers and grow your business, or you have some clients who need to do that, you can go to my website, webelieveingrowth.com, click on the events link, and it'll guide you through, and we'll see you Thursday at 3 o'clock. Scott with Action Coach, I'm here to help. Thank you. By the way, when did I say my name? At the end.
At the end.
What do most networking events like BNI and BNI is good, I'm not knocking them, tell you. Say your name first. Do any of you care about my name or do you care about my content? You're at a networking event. Do you care if it's John, Jane, or Joe? No, but what's their content? Do I want to book a meeting? So I engaged, I asked a question. I connected emotionally. Who feels they can double their business in COVID? There's going to be an emotional response there. What I'm offering is compliments. I'm offering something. And the actionable step was sign up for my workshop. Oh, one thing I forgot to say, I said, and by the way, if you don't have time and you want just a complimentary coaching session just to talk specifically about your business, go to webelieveingrowth.com under the coach's calendar and book a 30-minute complimentary coaching session. We can just talk one-on-one too. Or come see me afterwards, and we'll get on the calendar now. So think about your script. Are you doing something along that line? All right? Like I said. And then write it down and practice. I am not kidding. When we're allowed to go back out there again, if you see me, if you pull up next to me in the parking lot at whatever restaurant that we're going to be networking at, ask me, knock on my window. Don't worry, I won't mind if you have a glove on or not. And say, show me your script, and I will reach down and pull it out and show it to you. I read it right before there. One of my clients, we were talking yesterday because we're doing sales training just for her team, and she says right before she goes through it, you know, in the morning while she's getting, you know, doing her hair, brushing her teeth, she's saying her script over and over again in the mirror. Her kids will come in and they'll laugh at her. Mom, what are you doing? Got to get ready. Practice, practice, practice. So I'm going to rest my voice because you guys heard enough. I want everyone to write out or your 30-second script. So I'm going to go back to the next slide for a second so you have it. I want you to take 3 minutes, write it out or have it in your head, and hopefully a couple of you will be willing to share. Sound good? If you have questions, you can write it in the chat box. And by the way, now's a great time to give your script because guess what? You have other business owners. This can be a networking event for a few minutes. That's the great thing about the Action Coach community is we get to network. Give you guys one more minute. Start trying to wrap it up. Be ready to give your elevator pitch to all the people you get to network with here. All righty. By the way, did you guys, a little tip if you're ever doing events like this and you got music in between, do you notice how we softly took the music down a little bit? One, it doesn't shock you. Two, it gets people ready to pay attention again. Just a little tip that my coach gave me. All right. Who wants to go first and give their 30 seconds? I'm going to call on, we'll just do a couple of them because I know we still have a lot of stuff to go through today. Nancy, I'm going to call on you because I've listened to yours a whole bunch of times since we networked together. So I'm going to let you go if that's okay.
I don't do it the way you do it.
That's okay.
I say my name first, which is bad, I guess.
One thing I will always say, as I say in every training I've done, you got to make it your own. This is about giving you the components of a strong foundation. If you want to say your name first, go for it.
Okay. Hi, everyone. My name is Nancy Kuzniski, and I own the Nancy K Insurance Agency. We're an independent group. That means that we can offer 45-plus companies to place your insurance. So if you have auto, home, a business, any type of motorcycle, RVs, basically anything that you could own, we can insure. When was the last time you spoke to your agent? Has it been 2 years, 5 years, 10 years? If you want somebody that's interactive in your life, make sure that your insurance is the way it should be, then you need to give me a call. Nancy K with the Nancy K Insurance Agency. If your insurance is a mess and you can't find your way, pick up the phone and call Nancy K.
Awesome. I love the rhyme in the end. Had all the components, I'm just going to make one suggestion. Connect emotionally, which means your question on when's the last time your agent called you.
Yes.
Start with that.
Right.
So that they're like, oh, yeah, I haven't gotten a call from my agent. Then you're going to quickly tell them what you do and why they should call you.
Okay.
That'd be the only tweak. Otherwise, you had all the components in there. Just a little bit of flip-flop. Does that make sense?
Yeah. And just a little bit awesome. Of awe and hums and all that.
Wait, I'm putting you guys on the spot.
Yes, you are. That's okay.
Great job, Nancy. Thank you.
Thank you.
All right, who else wants to do one? I want to do one more, whoever wants to go. Whoever unmutes first, I'm looking at them all. Come on, someone.
I would like to try.
Awesome. Go for it, Sherry. Thank you.
Thank you. So I'm pretty new, but I would try. Okay. So today I am offering feedback on changes that needs to be taken care of regardless of COVID-19. How many times have you passed by or seen on TV someone just pleading for help for changes in society? I myself am finding ways to help everyone share their personal stories. I am a journalist.
Awesome. Really good. Really good. You can be stronger in your emotional connection by asking the question at the beginning of that. You brought up something everyone's going to be emotional about. Connect with them right away by asking a question in regards to that to start. Does that make sense?
Yeah, that sounds really nice. Thank you for your help.
You're welcome. And then you go into, I'm a journalist and here's what I do and here's how I'm connecting, you know, da, da, da. And then at the end, give them an actionable idea. How can they connect with you? How can you interact with them? Hey, come see me afterwards. I'd love to just do a one-on-one with you to get to know you, to interview, whatever it may be. Just add that last part and you're great to go. Thank you. So does that make sense, everyone? Kind of the components and structure. Sales is all about connecting emotionally. We all agree with that. So you want to connect right away. So in every sales stage, go back to the scripts for the sales stage. How do we connect emotionally right away? Bring in the empathy, right? We're more apt to do business with someone who I feel has empathy and understands my problems, right? If we can, so we want to connect right away when we do that. It's a good job. All right. Target market, shooting fish in a barrel. I grew up watching with Calvin and Hobbes. I'm a big Calvin and Hobbes fan. Hope, can you guys see that? Good. He just was mean to Susie, right? I believe that was her name. It's like shooting fish in a barrel. But that's what target market is. So asking a similar question I've asked a few times. Who here right now could rattle off exactly who their target market is? Who feels that they know that, nailed it, they got it, right? Now, for some of us, by the way, our target market might be everyone. And that's okay. But can we know it? Because once we know it, think about it. Look at, who are your current customers? Think about your customer base, the old 80-20 rule. We hear that on a lot of different things. Typically, 80% of our profits come from 20% of our client base. And that's in my notes because I probably wouldn't have remembered that. So I have my scripts here. Look at your current customers. What's the makeup of them? And were they your target market? Are they your target customer? Right? Why do they buy from you? You've got all this great data to use in your current customer base. Right? Now, for Nancy, you're one of your target customers are someone who owns a car, someone who owns or rents a house. So you have a very broad target market. But like you do in your different 30-second speeches I've heard, sometimes you focus just on car insurance or you just focus on homeowners and you focus with a script to just do that. Because once you get them, so you gave one of the answers earlier, hey, once I have their homeowners insurance, now it's easy to double my customers. Do you have auto? Do you own a boat? Do you own a business? Right? All that stuff. For others, it's more focused in what your target is and understand who they are. Right? Who are your competitors? If you know your target, you know who they're also shopping with. Right? Who are their customers? Does that fit your target? What products and services do you provide? Think about that. When you think about your target, does it match the products and service? Do they want your products and service? Or have you come up with a great product and service where now you have to see who wants it? You gotta have defined target. Think about this, right? Who also needs your products and service? Would you rather cast your net into the big ocean hoping to get some fish and not knowing what fish you're going to get? Or would you rather walk up to a barrel of salmon if you want salmon and know you can just pull them out? That's what knowing your target market is when it comes to sales and marketing. If you don't know that, how do you know where the barrel is and what's in that barrel? Because now you're just fishing in a big old ocean. So, what are some of the things we look at when we look at customer profile? A whole lot of stuff here, right? Think about this. That's a lot to think about, isn't it? That's what's in target. So think about that when you look at profiling who your customers can be. Because then we know which one of my clients this week in the coaching session, they're shifting their business into a new product or service we're going to launch. They need to shift where they go for networking because their target market's not at the places they've been going. Is your target market at the places you're networking at or where you are in Facebook versus LinkedIn? Right? I think we can go through this piece a little fast just because I want to make sure we get through some other stuff today. Right? All make sense? If we know our target, we can communicate in their language. Again, communication isn't what I say, it's what you hear. If I know who my target is and what's important to them, what their pain points are, then I can focus on their needs through the languaging I use, and I can have a clearer message. Think about that in your 30-second speech. Maybe one networking you go to, it's selling one of your products, the other network's a different product. You're not going to have the same 30-second speech at both of them. You're going to use a different one. But when you go to that event, you're going to use that same speech over and over again. Be repetitive, you know, and that's going to increase your conversion rates. So I want you to just take less than a minute to write in the chat box one characteristic of your ideal customer, your client. So if everyone can just take the next 60 seconds and just write one, think about your A client. You should be rating your clients A, B, C, and D, by the way. Think about your A client. And then this is an exercise you should be doing afterwards. So if you just want to write that in the chat box, just one characteristic of what you consider an A client.
I can't find my chat box.
Here, hopefully that pops something up. I sent you a chat.
There we go. Thank you. Okay.
Married with children. Yep. I like that. Client that will become a repeat customer. Now the next thing, the next level is understanding what would make them, why would they want to be a repeat customer? But that's a great start. Awesome. Good stuff. So think about that. I want you to think about that as you think about your business, you think about your scripts. We know who we're talking to. We can tailor our scripts to connect with them and our marketing message. We also need to know, though, what is our unique selling proposition? So types of USP. There's two, really. There's the perceived, where the customer perceives a difference in uniqueness. Now, sometimes what we think our USP is not what our clients and customers think is our USP. So maybe you do a survey with your clients every now and then. What do you think makes us special? Why'd you buy from me? You know, why would you buy from me again? You know, when there, and the actual is when there's an actual difference in process, right? Certain products, it's absolute cars. There's absolutely a difference between a Ferrari and a Ford, right? A station wagon and a sports car. But sometimes it's not so easy, and we have to be able to articulate what our USP is. So, you know, I want you to think, what is your USP? And if anyone wants to share it, go for it. Anyone want to unmute and share their USP?
What is it?
Go for it. Share it. Is that you?
I'm sorry. No, it wasn't. I don't know.
Okay. No worries.
I will.
Go for it.
You don't have to pay so much for great coverage.
That's a great one. It's on price, but it says more than just she. What I loved about what you just said, Nancy, is you didn't say we're the cheapest.
No.
And there's a difference. I'm not sure if everyone caught what Nancy said. She said you don't have to pay a lot for great coverage. She's really talking value. She said it in the right messaging. Great job there, Nancy. In the messaging that talks about value, I get a lot. That's awesome. Without really saying but they might get a feel I get a lot, and it's cheap too. But the focus is on the value. That's awesome. And that's a great, think about when you can get your message to do that. So good job. So again, as I like to call, we don't call homework at Action Coach, we call it home fun. I want you to write this down. What is my USP? And email it to me. We talked earlier about what our target customer is. Email it to me. You see my email at the bottom there. Scott F. as in Finkelstein at actioncoach.com. I want you to do some of this stuff over the next couple of days. Take some time and think about it and email it to me. And I absolutely will respond. And obviously, these are some of the things we can talk about. As we said, we can do in a 30-minute coaching session. If you just want to, for your 30 complimentary coaching session, just focus on your USP, we can do that. In the 75-minute business strategy session, we're going to talk a lot of this stuff. Not all of it, but we're definitely going to talk so we can get you in the right direction. Couple of things to think about in USP. Right? So it's speed of service. It's breadth of range. Scarcity. Level of service. One of my clients is a realtor. One of the biggest parts of his unique selling proposition is what we call his SLAs, his service level agreement, which we're going to talk about in guarantees in a minute too. A guarantee to show up on time. Sometimes realtors aren't always the most punctual. I guarantee I will not show you a house outside your price range. How many have worked with realtors over the years, and unfortunately some of them, oh, your budget's 200? I got a house for 400. Well, yeah, of course I love it, and the other one's going to look like crap. But that's not my price range. Now you upset me. Now I can't even see the value in that 200. That's one of his unique selling propositions, is he listens. Homer, I love Homer. He's great. So a little self-analysis. This is part of the home fun for you guys. And again, please email it to me. I'm happy to talk to you about this. Think about your three biggest competitors. What is their USP? This is the process, the system and process you need to go to come up with your USP. How do your customers make a purchase decision? All right, it's quality, price, image. In Simon Sinek's book, Starts With Why, he talks about Apple. The Apple phone's not the best, and it definitely is not the cheapest. But it has an image, and you either are an Apple user or you're not. You're an iMac or you're not. And someone, especially when they first started coming out, if they had an iPhone, versus a BlackBerry, a Samsung Galaxy, a Droid, it says something about who you are. Is your product and service something like that? What do you do differently from your competition? Think about that. So when you go back to the things we looked at, these are the questions you want to ask yourself as you come up with your USP. Okay. And if any of you, if there's certain slides, obviously you can screenshot them and all that and say, hey, can you send me the USP slides? You can shoot me that email as well. And I'll get pieces of this presentation to you. If there's somewhere you want to focus, you want to see more of this. I know this is why it's a two-day training with companies, because we actually will sit here and we'll spend anywhere from 1 to 2 hours on developing their USP. And then we go into scripts, because now we know what our USP is. How do we put that into a script? All right. Now, guarantee. We all love a guarantee, don't we? So what's your competitor's guarantee? Why don't you think about what your guarantee is? What is your industry guarantee? The coaching industry, we can guarantee return on investment. You coach with us and then you spend $1,000 a month, we guarantee you'll get your money back in the first 3 months, 6 months, depending Action Coach has a guarantee, 17-week guarantee. That's tied to the return on investment. In the insurance world, Nancy can't guarantee certain things because she's selling the insurance, but she absolutely guarantees the service. And that's what she says in her 30-second speech, right? So think about that. What would you love to guarantee? My realtor cannot do a money-back guarantee. Now, my HVAC client, there's absolutely a manufacturer's guarantee on a new air conditioner or heating unit he sells you, right? If you're selling cars, there's a guarantee. I mentioned earlier, service agreement guarantee. That's your SLAs. I work with my clients when we coach to actually type up 3 to 5 SLAs that are part of your guarantee and even go on the back of, I don't have a business card handy. Some put it on the back of their business card. Here's my business card. On the back is my SLA. Now, when I hand you my business card, I'm not handing you the front, assuming we can all meet again in person, which I know we will. I'm handing you the back because you're going to look at that and be like, that's different. Now it's going to start a conversation. Right? SLAs. What else we got? Do you guarantee in writing? So, all right. Let's spend a little time on critical drivers and KPIs. Keith Cunningham. I have the book here. This is a good thing about doing a workshop from home is I can reach back on my desk versus if I'm at the UT club. One of my favorite books and a lot of what we're about to talk about here comes from this book, The Ultimate Blueprint for an Insanely Successful Business. Sound familiar to one of the early slides, right? The Ultimate Blueprint came from this book. Keith Cunningham, by the way, he lives in Austin. Prior to all this, he does a lot of workshops.
Yes, hi, it's Nancy Kuzniewski. It's about 4:40 on Thursday afternoon.
So let's talk critical drivers. He says, most business owners make the mistake of only measuring KPIs. That's the lagging indicators. When they could and should be taking preemptive action by creating and measuring critical drivers. If we want our sales team to do the right activities, we have to measure it. What gets measured is what gets managed. Measure the results, change activities. Now, for every business, your critical drivers and your KPIs are different. We all probably have for our KPIs sales, revenue. That's probably one. That's a lagging indicator. But what gets us there? These are the performance standards we're setting. And in your training and in your playbook and in your system, you have to have these defined. Now, during the COVID crisis, for some of our clients, we've changed some of the KPIs because we're shifting how we're doing our business. So think about that. What are the critical drivers? These are the leading indicators. They help predict the future. If you're making sales calls, if you're doing cold calling, what do you think one of the numbers you got to look at is? How many calls did you make today?
The calls you make, how many reaches?
Yeah, and then what's the next one? After reaches, what do you think the next one is?
Appointments.
You got it. What's our conversion rate? How many appointments did we book? Well, if we know, so I had a sales team of over 15 inside salespeople at the last company I ran before I bought my franchise. We had KPIs. They all had a hit. That was a lot of how they got their raises, their bonuses. We're going to talk compensation plans. Now, one of my reps, who was always one of the top two every year, they were supposed to make 80 phone calls a day. He made 60. He had a significantly, almost a double conversion rate to the next step in the sales funnel, the sales stages, that he could make 25% less phone calls and actually still sell more. So as a sales manager, what I do, what as a leader, I wanted to connect with his with him. What's in it for me? He wanted to make a certain amount of money. And he was getting there by just doing less work. So I said, well, what if you made 30% more money? What would that do for your life? I connected emotionally in his one-on-one. And he goes, yeah, well, you know, I could fund college for my two. He had two young daughters. You know, he'd like to buy real estate. He was an investor. I could buy more properties. I could take my, you know, parents on a nice vacation. So what if you make 70 phone calls instead of 80 at the same conversion rate? And we're able to back that into his compensation. So as you're going to hear, critical drivers, KPIs are going to be attached. We're going to talk compensation plans. It all attaches, right? And it's going to predict, it's going to drive the right activity. And you have to be careful. You don't want KPIs and critical drivers that push people to the wrong activity. Understand that. Reduce the lag in faulty decisions. We need to be monitoring KPIs. And we typically have about critical drivers. We should have about 3 to 5 of them. And by the way, I know we're talking sales, but in operations, they have KPIs and critical drivers. In the financial, the CFO department, same thing. And for your business, I know sometimes you're all those departments. You're going to have critical drivers and KPIs for sales, for customer retention, for the financial side of your business. They're going to tell us when things are going wrong before we know. So before it becomes too late. That's what's so important about critical drivers. All right. So I put the question there, but we already did it. What are some of the critical drivers as we talked about? Number of calls, what's your conversion rate to number of appointments? The conversion rate is actually the critical driver, which would be the key predictable indicator that we'd look at, right? What's the time from cold call to winning a deal? That's something we're going to look at too. Every business is different. Again, when we get together in a coaching session, we can talk about yours if you just want to focus on that in your complimentary coaching session. We work on this as when we coach you as a client, we're looking at KPIs and actually looking at the results on a regular basis. It's part of coaching. From critical drivers, we do go to the KPIs, and that's the scoreboard. How do we keep score? Who's winning the game? One of the biggest scores is what's the revenue coming in? How many clients do we have? Did we win? This is what's going to tell us. Compensation is a scoreboard for your sales team, including yourself. How much money am I making? Again, has to drive the right activity. And it's tied to the organizational goals. If you want to double your customers, that's the organizational goal. How does this tie in each sales rep? So if your goal is to add $50,000 of revenue this year, or maybe it's $500,000. Well, each sales rep that's not their goal. They get a piece of that goal. And what are the KPIs to help get them there and the critical drivers? So there's the individual that go to a team, that go to a division, that go to the whole company. Each piece. So again, this is why this is a two-day offsite workshop. How do we build all these? This is what we coach on when we coach you in your business. And a lot of people are like, well, I'm a small business. It's just me, or just me and 5 other people or 20 other people. I don't need this. Yes, you do. How do you know if you're doing the right activities yourself as a sole proprietor? How do you know if someone on your team is productive? Is there something in the system we need to tweak so we get more productivity out of it? This is what's going to tell them. Does that make sense? Okay. We review often. So let's get into the comp plan. Let's have a little fun here. Let's see if we can get this going. Internet's moving a little slow. Everyone remember that movie? But that's what compensation is. That's what sales is, right? Show me the money. Even if you're a sole proprietor to yourself, You want to make money. Who is Bob Sugars? That's his competition. His only client was saying, I might go to the competition. So think about that from a sales standpoint, whether it's from people on your team. You got to have the right compensation model. If you want the best people, you got to have the right compensation model. So that's tied, though, to your critical drivers. Obviously, your KPIs is revenue. You get paid on revenue. Maybe they get a bonus for high conversion rates or the number of appointments. You can add things in like that. Tied to organizational goals. We want our reps to be hungry, but not starving. Otherwise, they start looking for other jobs. And I never understood a company that caps compensation. If you sell more, you make more. As you see my quote up at the top, you want a raise? Sell another deal. You want a rep who wants to make $1 million? Go sell another deal. I'll pay you the same commission, or I'll maybe pay you a higher commission. Make sure it's easy to understand and calculate. And reward overachievement. So when you hit certain goals, you get paid a higher commission rate, or maybe you get a bonus. Because typically the more they sell, the higher your profit margin is on those bigger sales, because your fixed costs are part of those sales. So they shrink. Your profit margin increases. Give some of that back to reward them, to give them an incentive to go sell more. Does that make sense? So we want high achievement. We got to have the right training program. As Brad Sugar says, your business will only grow as much as you do. He goes on to say, if you're not learning, you're stuck in the mud. That's a paraphrase. He doesn't use mud, but I'm using it. This is why you're here today, to learn, to grow. This is part of your training program. So I'm going to go through this pretty quick, but you got to have a training manual. The systems and process manual, that's part of your training manual. How to get an A. One of the companies I used to work for, our CEO came in and talked about how to get an A. That's what we called our review every quarter for all our team members. It was your report card, how to get an A. So what's an A mean? Does it mean I sold five new widgets today? My clients come back and buy again every 3 months. Ties to the KPIs and the organizational goals. Again, systems and process. It's all part of your sales playbook. This is all in the training. Let your top reps train your new reps. Let them train each other. I like to call snack size training. So when you have, so obviously if you're a sole proprietor, you're going out to things like this to get trainings for you. When we coach, we'll come in and do some training for your team. That can be part of a coaching program. But how are you training your team? Snack size. Just do a 10-minute training every Friday. Doesn't have to be anything formal. Get everyone quick 10-minute training on something you think everyone's struggling with, or you've noticed when you look at the critical drivers. Hey, our conversion rate's going down. Let's do a quick 10-minute training to reinforce scripts. Training versus coaching. When we're in spring training, I'm a baseball guy and can't wait for it to hopefully come back. In spring training, we're not winning games. We're working on the fundamentals. But then when we get into a game, we coach. We don't break down fundamentals, it's just small tweaks. And if you're always in training with your team and yourself, it's hard to have a lot of success because you're slowing down. When you get past the, I got the fundamentals, now it's just small tweaks, the coaching, that's when that line goes like this and skyrockets up. Support their success, that's what training's all about. Mentor programs. If you're a sole proprietor, find a mentor out there. Who's your mentor? I've got two coaches and one mentor in my life. Two coaches I pay for, one mentor. I guess I pay for him because he makes me take him out to dinner or buy him drinks. And finally, we need to celebrate the wins. Anyone want to share a celebration they did for a win they've had recently or even in the last 6 months for themselves or for their team? Who wants to share one win they celebrated? I'll start. Go ahead and unmute. For me, I love wine. So when I hit certain revenues in a month, I go buy myself a nice bottle of wine, sit outside, and enjoy it. And then I don't always share. Anyways, anyone else want to share a quick win? All right, think about that. Especially in time of stress and crisis, There's something we win at every day. Sometimes the win is I got out of bed and I brushed my teeth. Find ways to celebrate for you and for your team. So Jim Rohn, never wish your life were easier. Wish you were better. Work harder on yourself than you do on your job. Again, I can't congratulate you guys enough for being here today and working on you. That's why you're going to be successful, why you're going to double your customers. And if you need help to get there, that's what coaching is all about. Brad Sugars, where you'll be in 5 years will depend on the books you read. And that means learning. It can be a book, it can be a workshop. The people you associate with, who are you hanging around with? Are you hanging out with the high performers? Are you lifting them up? Are they lifting you up? Are you at the right networking places? In the actions you take, you gotta take action to be successful. So who's ready to get in action? This is always, I say this all the time. I don't want this to become shelf knowledge where you guys take what you learned, you took notes and you put it up on a shelf somewhere and you do nothing. 85% of people, they do nothing. Reward your hard work. Reward your 2 hours you just spent today learning by actually taking action now. Like I said, we have two offers for you, and they don't cost you anything. Take action now. Right? For those that want coaching, we can get to one-on-one coaching. That's personal and face-to-face when we're allowed to and over the phone right now. For businesses with high potential for growth, we do ask you, you got to work commit to 4 to 5 hours each week on your business. And it's easily affordable. We got some group programs starting at $7.45. And for our larger companies, goes obviously up above that, and where we do a whole bunch of things, including offsites, you name it. But we can find a program that's affordable to you. It includes Growth Club, myself. There's two other Action Coach offices in the greater Austin area. Every quarter we get all our clients together. This quarter it was virtual. We had about 30 people on what we call Growth Club, which is our 90-day planning. So we spend 90 days. We spend 4 to 5 hours together and we do our 90-day plan. And that's what guides us for that quarter in the coaching. Every time we coach, every time we get together, it's our roadmap. It gives us our roadmap. And coaching is about, great, I've learned this. I've got a roadmap. Coaching is helping you take action, walking by your side and helping you be proactive and make sure you do what you need to do, accountability in it. And we do guarantee our results as we talked about. So let's get into action. If you want to get into coaching, just come, you know, send me in the box right there. I see a couple people already did it. They've requested some 30-minute sessions. Type in what you want. Do you want the 30-minute or the 75? Type that in, and I'll make sure we get you on the calendar. Also, you can go to our calendar on WeBelieveInGrowth.com, Coach's Calendar, and pick the one you want. Now, if you do the business strategy session, there are three rules. I think it's fair. Number one, you got to book it. You got to let me know today or go to the Coach's Calendar today before you go to bed tonight. And book your 75-minute time slot, or let me know and I'll get that to you. And I'll do that in the next few hours before the night goes away. Number two, when you do that, we're going to send you what we call a business background questionnaire. It's take you about 10 to 12 minutes to fill out. It gives us a whole bunch of information so we can start doing some research and start working for you already, so that when we get into that strategy session, we've got some ideas already of what's going on in your business and where you need some help. Love it. I got a couple people already signing up what they want. So if you want that, that's rule number two. Rule number three, at the end of that strategy session, we ask you to make a decision. Yes, I'm going to go into coaching in one of the programs and we'll find one that's an investment that makes sense for your business and where you're at. Or number two, you decide I'm a DIY and you're going to do it yourself. Either one's fine. But we ask you to go to either one. Sound fair? Awesome. So again, you can go to our website, WeBelieveInGrowth.com. Type in the chat box before you get off. We don't have 100% participation. We got a couple left out there. And let us know what you want. We are at 5:00. I want to thank you guys so much. I can stay for 5 more minutes if anyone wants to talk and has a couple of questions. I'm here. Otherwise, I want to thank you guys. Continue to be safe out there. I'll see you at the next event, the next networking place. And just like I said, either go to the website and already schedule it or type it into the chat box. I'm going to stay on for a few minutes, but you guys, you can sign off if you're done. Thank you so much. I appreciate the opportunity. Thanks, guys.
Thank you.